You know you are the salt of the earth, don't you?
Yeah.
You're the salt of the earth. What would this world be like without believers? Man, I tell you, that would be a bad situation, wouldn't it?
Yes, it would.
Yes, believers are the ones that believe in the goodness of God. We believe in the greatness of God. We believe in the love of God. We believe. We live by faith. Isn't that right, Madison?
Yes.
We live by faith, not by sight. Andy was telling me today, this lady was saying, I don't believe in Jesus because you can't prove it.
Yeah.
We don't live by sight, do we? We live by faith. And once you live by faith, He opens your eyes to see it. It becomes so obvious after you believe. But if you don't believe, well, your eyes will be blinded. Blinded to the truth. So let's sing together, How Great Is Our God. He is great.
The splendor of a king. Let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice, trembles at his voice. How great is our God. Age to age, He stands.
Father, we praise you because of your greatness. You are great. There is nothing that you cannot do. You are mighty. You are powerful. We put our faith and trust in you because you're faithful, you're trustworthy, you're almighty God, and we're so thankful, Father, to know you. We're thankful that you have extended your grace to us. You've demonstrated your love for us, bringing us into the fold, allowing us to be your children, the very sons of God, the very daughters of God. Thank you so much for this great relationship we have with you. Thank you for allowing us to come together tonight to worship you as a church, as we gather together as believers in Christ. What a great opportunity. We realize as we celebrate the Memorial Day, Father, that many people have suffered and died in order to give us the freedoms that we enjoy here, and we are so grateful for them. Help us to take full advantage of these freedoms that we have in this country. We thank you and we praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's say together, great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. His greatness no one can fathom. Oh, that's interesting, isn't it? Don't even think about trying to figure it out. No one can fathom, really, how great God is. We sing praises to him because he's great, but we're just scratching the surface, aren't we? We're still learning. We're learning more and more. What a day it's going to be when we see Jesus face to face. Don't you think that's going to be a little bit shocking? That is going to be shocking when we see Jesus face to face. Let's sing, How Great Is Your Love.
From the darkness, I called your name. Into darkness, your mercy came. You called me out, lifted me up. How great is your love?
Remember that love lifted me?
He bore my weakness. He took my shame. Buried my burdens in fields of grace. You called me out, lifted me up. How great is your love?
Do you believe it? Do you believe it? You know, when the Bible says, I was talking to Jay this morning after church, and that's the really big question that comes about as far as the gospel is concerned. You know, what does it take to be saved? Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, thou shalt be saved. God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Well, the real question is, do you believe God loves you? You know, because the other thing, well, I just can't believe in a God that would do this, or I can't believe in a God that would do that. So many people, that's what you'll hear if you witness to them about Jesus Christ, and they think God is not good. So really, essentially, you have to believe that God loves you, that he loves you enough to send his own Son to die for your sins, and that he loves you enough to direct you in your life, that he would never ask you to do something that wasn't in your best interest. You know, we may not understand it, and it may not seem like it's in our best interest at the time, right? We go through tough times, really tough times, and it may not seem like it, but do we still believe that he loves us? Do we still believe that he loves us? That he's got our best interest at heart? That's what God is calling us to do. That's the gospel. Whoever believes in him will be saved. Of course, we all grow in that, don't we? We're all growing in our ability to understand how much God really does love us. But it is really the essence of our relationship with Christ, is truly believing that he would love us enough to send Jesus to die for our sins and direct us in our life and take care of us and provide for us all the way through life. We trust him. We believe in him. Let's read this together. Your love, Lord, reaches to the heavens, your faithfulness to the skies. It's heavenly, isn't it? It's not something from this earth. It's out of this world. The love of God is out of this world. It reaches to the heavens, your faithfulness to the skies. That's powerful. Well, let's sing about the goodness of God. You know, this is a song we haven't done before. I don't know it real well myself, but you help me.
Of the goodness of
know, I think that was the song that the woman at the well was singing, don't you?
Yeah.
Running after her. He said, he must needs go through Samaria. He had to go through there. There was a reason for it. Isn't that beautiful? He's running. And really, that's the only reason any of us ever got saved. God kept running after us. The Bible says no man ever seeks after God. It's God who's seeking after us. He's running after us. And, you know, he's just longing for us to come into his arms and receive the salvation that he has for us, all the blessings that he has for us. He has such a great life in store for us, walking with him, and it's going to last for all of eternity. Let's read this verse together. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the one who takes refuge in him. You will be blessed as you take refuge in the Lord, as you find that you can trust him, as you find that he will always love you. He'll never leave you. He'll never forsake you. You re-experience the blessings of God. Well, I guess Nancy's not doing too well tonight.
Yes.
Is she coughing?
She needs to stay. I've got her coughing. Yeah, she's all right, but it's just better she stay in.
She's still dealing with that cough, though, right?
Yeah, when it starts, it's still kind of rugged, but it's getting better.
Yeah, I bet singing is not really all that good for it either. It's got to stimulate that cough. Marie?
My singing to her is not good for.
Oh, I see. Have you learned that?
Yeah.
I see. Well, that's good to pick up on things like that. You know, wives will give you a clue every now and then.
That's right. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's really good, isn't it, Craig? That's good to have clues like that for people that will that care about you, you know, and they'll let you know, you better not sing right now. That's great. Okay, so Marie, I talked to Dick. She seems to be doing a little bit better. She was getting her hair fixed and hoping to be able to go to work on Tuesday, so that sounds good. Sounds pretty good that she's optimistic about getting better. So, but she's still having a pretty rough time, so we'll need to pray for them. Of course, Bobby's got his biopsy coming up on Friday.
Friday.
Friday. Yeah. And Phil, he's got an echocardiogram on Saturday.
Thursday.
Oh. Oh, Thursday the 29th, isn't it?
No, 30th is Thursday.
The 30th is Thursday. Okay. Okay.
And the 30th is
Thursday?
Yes. Why am I thinking Friday?
So, Friday's, well, Thursday, then the Friday would be the 31st then, right?
Friday's
yeah.
The 31st.
Yeah, because Sunday's June 2nd.
And Liz is leaving on the 1st.
Okay, oh. So the 29th is Thursday?
Don't you think that you could stay one more day?
What?
Can you stay one more day? Just one more Sunday with us?
I've been home. I have a lot planned.
You've got a lot of stuff planned. Well, it's been great having you here. It sure has been. Always good to have you here. You usually try twice a year, right? Uh-huh. So summertime and then at birthday time.
Right.
Uh-huh. Well, this has been great to have you here. I hope you have, we'll pray for a good trip home.
Thank you.
Yes, you bet. And how about Ronnie and Kathy? Did they have COVID? They said this morning they've got COVID.
Yeah.
When did they get COVID?
I have no idea when they were diagnosed. Do you know when?
No, just the other day.
Uh-huh. All of a sudden they weren't feeling good, got tested,
yeah.
Found out it was COVID. Okay. Well, I kind of wondered if Marie might have COVID. You never know. It sounds a little bit like that with fever and cough and stuff like that. But
no, not sure.
Man, aren't you thankful that COVID's not like it used to be?
Yes.
Wow, that was a really tough time. Really tough time. Let's pray for all the people with allergies. I know Kendall, she's really been suffering with that.
Well, so is her fiance. He was sitting there today struggling too.
Is that right?
He said his allergies were him.
Oh, yeah.
Of course, he's been out in the wheat harvest too, so that wheat dust doesn't help any.
That doesn't help, that's for sure. Uh-huh. Yeah. You bet. So, Chad, are they starting to get that weed out?
They are. Yeah, it really kind of kicked off 3 or 4 days ago.
Okay. And the rain, does it not hold them back? Are they still able to... If it rains in the morning, can they still cut in the afternoon?
Well, it depends on if the wind blows and how dry it is.
If it dries out good.
A lot of times it can.
It's all just about moisture at this point, isn't it?
It is.
Yeah. We pray for moisture all year long until wheat harvest, right?
Yeah, you want it to be dry.
Yeah, you bet. God knows the right combination, doesn't he?
He does.
Sunshine and rain. Any other prayer requests?
Just please be in prayer for Holly. Bye.
Yes, have you talked to her?
No, I have not. Ruth Ann has been in contact with her, though, and that's where we got her information.
It's got to be disheartening for her. I know it would be for Joan if she were to get a second diagnosis. That would be really, really hard for her. I bet it is for Holly, too. And I didn't realize that her father was one of the elders here at the at First Christian Church.
Her grandfather, Merle Hoover, was absolutely the pillar of this church. If there was anybody you wanted to model after, it was that man. He was a true, we all felt he was a true Christian. He showed it, he lived it.
Was he also an elder?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, Merle Hoover. And but Holly's father's name is what?
Bruce
Hoover?
Oh,
yeah, I guess it would be. Okay. I didn't know them at all, you know. And what's the other daughter's name?
Candy,
yeah. I didn't know them, didn't know who they were. So when you mentioned about Holly, I looked up Bruce's obituary, and I saw in there how active he was here at First Christian Church. And so that was a blessing to me to know that they have such a powerful history.
He was an educator, and he lived on Indian reservations and worked for the Bureau of
Indian Affairs.
Indian
Affairs. Yeah, that's what I read. That was his primary career, was educating the Native Americans.
And Gail, his wife, had horrible rheumatoid arthritis. Her hands are very crippled, and she did the most beautiful needlework, small needlework you ever saw.
Well, I'll be. Isn't that something?
And the turquoise, and she always was this.
Yes.
Very.
So she was really big into turquoise?
Both of them were.
Oh, well, I guess with the Native American culture, they had access to all that. I know Rita would be interested in that, no doubt.
Well, and the reason why we have a chrismon tree is because of Gail. She was making a bunch of chrismons one year for her home.
Oh, okay.
And we got to looking at them and finding out about them, and we decided that we would start one. And of course, for several years, we got to hang hers on our tree.
Oh.
But when she passed away, we gave them back to the family.
Right. I'm sure they wanted those. Yeah, well, I love that chrismon tree. I think that's really special. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for taking care of us, looking after us. We just depend upon your goodness. As we see your goodness, we are reminded more and more of your great love for us, which no man can fathom. No one can even possibly begin to understand just how much you really do love us. But we see a glimpse of that, Father, in your willingness to send your own Son, the one whom you loved, your one and only Son, to sacrifice him on the cross of Calvary for our sins, to make it possible for us to have a relationship with you. We were lost, we had no hope, and yet you were the one that brought us to yourself. You opened our eyes to see your goodness, and you gave us the ability to put our faith and trust in you. And as we put our trust in you, Father, it's just amazing to see how you continue to reveal more and more of yourself to us. For all these requests that have been mentioned, we lift them up to you. We know that you're able to heal those who need healing. You're able to comfort those who need comfort, strengthen those who need strength. Father, we just are thankful that you are there to supply every need. And so we commit each one of these people to you at this time, trusting you to provide what they need. We pray this prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
And I'm sorry, I want to lift up Don Dick Dunham.
Okay.
He's been having some health issues, and he had a procedure done Friday. And
had a balloon.
He had a balloon.
Balloon done in his artery.
Okay, so there was a heart problem.
Yeah, so we're hoping he gets better.
Yes, exactly. Oh man, those are all complications of diabetes, aren't they? He has real bad diabetes, doesn't he?
Yes.
Yeah, right. So we'll just keep praying for him. Absolutely. Add him to the list. Praying for Don Dick. Okay. Thank you so much. Let's sing another song. Let's sing I Believe. Do you believe?
I believe.
You believe. Good. Thank you. Thank you for that testimony. Anybody else?
I believe.
Oh, good. Good. Absolutely. Thank you. Thank you. Tonight is testimony night.
Well, we're all here because we believe.
Thank you. That's a great point. We wouldn't be here otherwise, would we?
I don't believe
that. That's exactly right. We're not here just to gain favor with the city of Frederick, are we? Okay, let's see. I believe.
One salvation, one doorway that leads to life, one redemption, one confession. I believe in the name of Jesus Christ. Hey! I believe in the crucifixion, by His blood I have been set free. I believe in the resurrection, hallelujah, His life is dead to me.
Father, we believe in the name of Jesus Christ. We know there's no other name given among men whereby we must be saved. What a powerful testimony, Father. Thank you for all those who have gone before us who have been willing to stand up for the glory of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Thank you for revealing it to the apostles as time went on after the resurrection of Jesus Christ, the ascension of Christ. The Holy Spirit came, revealed this glorious gospel, how we're saved by your grace, not by our works that we could possibly ever do, but by your grace you took us in and you gave us the power of the Holy Spirit to live in the righteousness of Christ. And that's our goal, Father, every day, to learn more and more about what it means to walk in the righteousness of Christ so that we can walk closer and closer to him. We pray that you bless each and every one of us, Father. Bless our families. We pray for each of our family members. We pray that you draw each one near to Jesus Christ. Help them also to see more and more of the glory of Jesus Christ as they walk day by day. We pray that you bless us as we go in to partake of the meal. Thank you for Rob and his willingness to prepare the meal. We pray for him, bless his family, and we'll give you the praise and glory. And we're thankful for the food. We ask you to bless it to our bodies. It's in Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you for singing loud enough to cover me.
I was singing loud tonight, wasn't I?